सो हाय, गुड इवनिंग फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू वन मोर एक्शन पैक्ड मास्टर क्लास ऑन टूल किट फॉर ग्रोथ एंड रिवाइवल ऑफ द बिजनेस. सो दिस इज द बिजनेस टूल किट वर्कशॉप, वेरी एक्सक्लूसिवली क्यूरेटेड फॉर द यंग बिजनेस ओनर्स. ओके, हाउ लॉन्ग डू वी वेट टू गेट बैक टू वर्क? We cannot be in the survival mode all the time. It's high time now we start thinking to be in the growth mode. Nor the government is going to help you, nor is the economy going to support you. People who make the difference are people who are going to take charge of things. So with this context, welcome to the masterclass brought to you by the prestigious Wellinker Institute of Management, the Entrepreneurship Cell and the Family Managed Business Program team at VSchool. Today, this next 45 minutes to 1 hour, we are going to dedicate to learn on some top 5 skills which we are going to be able to put in practice and use starting tomorrow morning. You know, this is not a gyan session, this is on how to really go to next level. That is our idea, and to do this we have a fantastic person today who has a combination, the wisdom of the old and the energy of the young. He has done traditional businesses and he is into new age businesses, so he has seen the both balances. So we have today Mr. Siddharth Prabhakar, who has worked on traditional businesses. He is one of India's top motivational speaker and trainer, has trained thousands and thousands of students and entrepreneurs to give them a direction in their personal and professional and business lives. Siddharth's another introduction is he is one of those top persons who does online curated e-commerce driven online educational program with the best names in the media and entertainment and the celebrity industry. So he runs a fantastic online school which is known as celebrityschool.com, and this is the school which has learnings and lessons from the likes of Nawazuddin Siddiqui to Sabira Merchant to Madhur Bhandarkar. So Siddharth has curated all this, so he understands what are the businesses of tomorrow and how to attract the millennials and the new age customers. So Siddharth is going to put together all of this wisdom in the next 45 minutes and going to help us to navigate through these challenging times. Siddharth, to introduce you to our audience, we have students and faculty members from the Wellinker Institute of Management. We have a lot of our alumni who have done the Entrepreneurship and Family Managed Business Program at Wellinker. We run it for last 2 decades almost, where people from across the country, entrepreneurs, come to us for a period of 11 months and they come in the Mumbai campus for 7 days every month. So this is the audience who we have, and we have a lot of business owners, entrepreneurs. As I told you, we were full with your webinar 2 days back. So we have got hundreds of messages saying ki boss, the capacity of 500 people is over 2 days back. So you can understand your popularity. So I'm handing over you the entire process now to you, Siddharth, and we look forward to a very, very power-packed next 1 hour. So
absolutely
all yours.
Thank you so much, Samir. Itna jhoot to meri mummy ne bhi mere liye nahi bola.
Kya baat hai.
But that was a lovely introduction. Thank you so much. And we have known each other for such a long time, and it's an absolute pleasure and honor to come on board, right, for VSchool and Yanku, both as such. And this is wonderful. Yeah, I mean, we are into a time when everyone is wanting entrepreneurs and relying on entrepreneurs to create something new, you know, create new things so that you know, job opportunities are developed. So this is wonderful. Thank you so much for having me here. So just going ahead, you know, just a small little story to begin with. Why I would say, you know, why I can actually give this business toolkits and all. This was some time back, you know, a nice 5-7 years back, you know, when I was actually standing in the line, you know, depositing money in the bank. And in front of me, Samir, I had, you know, the owner of a gas agency, you know, the gas, huge gas, LPG gas is what we use at home, you know. And then that it was those times, Samir, when you know, government was removing that gas and then putting pipelines, gas pipelines as such, you know. And I said, sir, aap bahut jyada thode se ghabraye hue rahenge, because another few months and pure Navi Mumbai mein you will have this gas pipes as such, you know, and aapka business jo hai वो बहुत ही डिप डाउन हो जाएगा, ऑलमोस्ट खत्म हो जाएगा. एंड समीर ही सेड समथिंग वेरी ब्यूटीफुल. ही सेड, यू नो व्हाट सिद्धार्थ, डू यू थिंक दैट वी वर 100% थिंकिंग ऑफ रिलाइंग ऑन द सेम बिजनेस मॉडल फॉर 100 इयर्स? No, we were not. We knew that something like this would come, and we were all ready and we were all prepared for it. And this actually hit me, Samir, and I thought, as an entrepreneur, this is what I should do. You know, I should not think that the same business model that I'm running or the same way I'm running my business is going to be operating for the next 50, 60, 70, 100 years. No, it's not going to be there. We run in an age today where technology is changing every day. I would say every 3 months you have a new app coming up. Every 4 months you have a new collaborative platform coming up. And sometimes as an entrepreneur, we get caught up. You know, we live in this bubble that, look, my business model is pandemic proof. My business model is recession proof. My business model is so well that it can run in just a similar fashion for the past next 50, 60 years. No, it's not gonna do that. And this corona pandemic has actually taught us, right, that similar situations are gonna come. Right. And I was just speaking to a few of my friends from the entrepreneurship industry and also from the medical industry. And they were telling me, Siddharth, this is just the beginning. Right. There are going to be so many things, maybe not as scary as the corona, but in similar veins. Right. And we will all have to adapt to this. So this is what all it happened. You know, we run a company called Floating Campus. Right. And we take sessions, physical sessions, Samir, in schools and colleges across India. So almost 1200 schools and colleges in India, we have a presence where all our trainers go physically and teach the students. We are absolute masters when it comes to career counseling. It's a very passionate product for us, right? Almost, I think last year we did about 4.5 lakh students, you know, who took this paper and pen career test from us, right? But then we knew and we realized that sometime, right, this physical interaction will stop. Not only corona, there may be just too many things as such. And we were all prepared for, I think we were few of the companies who were really prepared. So when this thing happened, even today, you know, we have our trainers at least taking 2 or 3 workshops across India in schools and colleges. Right. So we were almost always prepared as such. And that's when we had a discussion. We came up that let's have a session on, you know, how to get ready, what are the toolkits that are required, you know, to divert your business or, you know, make your business pandemic proof as such, right? So I have 5 very important things to share. We will go very slowly and we will go step by step. And as I said, all my sessions, I want it to be a very practical oriented session so that you can start implementing it from day one tomorrow itself. Why tomorrow? Start implementing it today itself. Right? So the first thing I think you should do is that you should ask your consumer, right? Most of the people, when something like this happens, I'll tell you, Samir, what they do. They sit inside their AC corporate office, right? Get the VP of sales, maybe the VP of finance, right? With the MD, and they try to brainstorm, oh, what can we do now? Right? Point number one, you have not faced a situation like this, right? So you cannot come up with an answer sitting inside a boardroom. The only person who can give you the most accurate answer is your consumer, right? So why not go and ask your consumer as to what do you want? For example, I'll tell you, when we started Celebrity School, Samir, right, where you have superstars, absolute mega stars like Nawazuddin Siddiqui teaching acting. You have Shan teaching singing. You have Madhur Bhandarkar teaching filmmaking. You have Sabira ma'am teaching communication skills. You have my business course as such, right? So everyone told us, oh, why don't you hire the best of the best in the industry, pay them ₹1 lakh a month, and they will sit and they will design this whole curriculum for you, right? Now that's one way of doing it. And Sameer, everyone does the same way, right? And we said, no, we don't want one person to sit inside a cubicle and decide what should the students learn. We want to go to the students and ask them what you want to learn. Right. So we actually went down to the schools and colleges and corporate companies where we take sessions. Right. And we met people. And I hate this concept of surveys that you make them fill up a survey form. You know, no one wants to fill up a survey form. They just want to answer a one very straight question asked with passion. Sir, you love acting. I love acting too. So if someone like Nawazuddin Siddiqui is teaching acting, what will you love to learn from him? That's it. No surveys. One question, right? And he's going to tell you 2-3 important points. Don't ask him 10 points and baffle him. Just ask him 2-3 important points. Take your notes, come back home and compile it, right? That's a very simple thing. Go out there, call up your consumer, right? Speak to them, right? Let all of your VPs and people who manage your business or the people who sell your retail product, you know, speak to your consumers, get that feedback, make a structure out of it, and then create a pandemic proof business model as such. Sameer, you agree what I said? Oh, I can't hear you, but That's fine.
Yeah. So it's very clear in our Japanese management technique program at VSchool, we teach talk to the consumer, go on the floor.
Absolutely.
Everything is irrelevant till the time we don't ask the person who is going to use it.
Wonderful.
Whether internal or external. So true.
True. Now, here is a very small little thing. Now, this is what Henry Ford said. You know, when you ask to the consumer, he said, if I went ahead and asked my consumer what you wanted, they might have said faster horses, right? And not necessarily a car. So you'll have to be a little careful how you ask it. Don't ask them how to do it. How to do it is your responsibility. How to make it tech savvy, how to deliver it, your responsibility. Just ask the consumer what they want, what are they looking for, and then go back and to your drawing board and create a product or a technology or an offering similar to that. Don't ask them how do you want to learn. You know, that's a very wrong approach as such, right? Second thing, what I have realized in this whole corona pandemic is that we are now moving in, Sameer, into something what I call the caring economy, right? You have seen the police, you have seen the doctors, you have seen the nurses, and you have seen even common men, you know, who go out of the way to help and support the people around them. Let it be elderly people in your society. Let it be the watchmen who have nowhere to go, right? We are into an economy now slowly where, as I said, you know, a caring economy. And if you are not into a business where you actually be part of this caring economy, right, you are not thinking long term, right? There's a beautiful saying by President Roosevelt of America. He said, no one cares how much you know till the time they know how much you care. I'll repeat this once again, Sameer. You know, this is what Roosevelt said. No one cares how much you know till the time they know how much you care, right? And then people moving ahead are going to be connected or buying from companies who are really caring for the society, really caring for the consumers. Gone are the days where you can sit and just keep making money without caring for the society, right? So you will have to now slowly get this caring economy mindset every day into your employees, right from your HR department, right from your sales department, right to the person who is touching the consumer. Look, We are a caring company. We are part of this caring economy and we are a caring company. So the first thing you should do is take care of him, see what situation he is in, how we can help him, and then go ahead and sell your product. For example, I'll tell you, my wife Sameer is obsessed with customer service, right? And she handles customer service for Celebrity School .in as such, right? We have around 12 people who day in, day out, just answer queries for people who are buying Sabira Merchant's course or Nawazuddin Siddiqui's course, because it's a new concept as such, yes. Right? And we make sure, for example, we had a very beautiful testimonial from a mother who asked my wife, you know, my son is 12 years old. Can he go ahead and buy Shan's course? It was very easy for us to say, oh yes, please go ahead and buy the course and he is going to become a superstar and we get that money in. Rather than that, you know, she actually spent 15, 20 minutes making sure that the mom, you know, really understands how the course is made, how she or someone elderly will have to sit with the child throughout the program and make him understand, right? She did it as part of the job. But then this mom, you know, went ahead and wrote about us on all the social media handles. She was an influencer. She was a teacher, actually. She went ahead and told this experience to everyone in her school. And we got some fantastic response. Now, this thing all happened because we as a company, Sameer, have this mindset of a caring economy.
In fact, right? I must add here, Siddharth, at Wellinkar, yes. One at the Wellinkar Institute of Management, one of the core values is we link and care. It's written wow. Everywhere in the campus. So wow. We link, we collaborate, and we care for everybody.
Wonderful.
So
wonderful.
Relevant. At this time of the year, you know?
Absolutely. Great. Absolutely. Absolutely. Great. Great. So coming to the second point, I personally believe that every business, Sameer, can be made pandemic proof, you know? So this is how you will have to approach it first, right? You will, I basically call this as the baby step model, you know. So what happens in the baby step model is that you sit down and you divide your entire customer acquisition to sale process into smaller segments, right? So let me give you a small little example here. I think it's easier to explain with an example. A near and dear friend of mine, Dr. Sumita Naram, who is the founder of a company called Ayushakti, right? Now, Ayushakti has done some great job during this pandemic. You know, they have really helped people. They went out of the way, distributed free medicines as such, right? So when this all started, I called up Smita ma'am and she said, oh yes, Siddharth, I'm worried because I run some 9-10 clinics and people are not coming to the clinics as such, right? And our sale of medicines are drastically dropped as such, right? But then now when I spoke to her a few days ago, she has again bounced back where there are people who are again buying the medicines, right? And possibly sometimes her sales is better than what it used to be, right? Now, how did she achieve this? She again achieved this by making her business pandemic proof by taking the baby steps. Now, again, what I mean by taking the baby step approach is that she divided her business, you know, into the smaller segments. She said, look, people come to me, they buy the medicines, right? Mm-hmm. And they go back. That's a very important part of my business, right? Now, people are not coming. So can I arrange something when if they are not coming, I can send the medicines to them,
sure,
right? So it can either be by courier or it can be someone from my organization delivering the medicines with a mask and a proper bag and keeping it below their society, right? Mm-hmm. Now, once this small little thing was tackled, right? She then went on to the next thing where people are not coming to the doctor. Right. So if they're not coming to the doctor, how will she generate new patients? And that's when she trained her doctors to look, online is the way to go. Decide a time and meet your patients and consumers online. Right. And then, of course, the third part was education. Right. You have to educate the consumers. As we said, You know, we are into a caring economy. You've got to educate the consumers. You've got to tell them the benefits. You've got to tell them what to do, what not to do, how to come online and meet the doctors, what questions to ask, what questions not to ask, right? So this is a small little baby step approach. You can't make the entire business model pandemic proof all at once. Trust me, Sameer, if you're going to do that, you're going to crumble. You're going to fall down, right? So rather than that, divide your entire business cycle, your entire cycle into smaller segments and units, and make that one unit pandemic proof, and then move on to the next segment as such.
I completely agreed, you know, and in fact, I would like to add here, Siddharth, it's so important that we break down the task into smaller tasks and complete one task after another. Now, it's not the time purely about multitasking, you know, because it may sound so easy. So what, we went and gave the medicines to somebody's house. But as we speak now, there are millions of business owners who have still even not thought about how does he deliver probably from one Borivali to Andheri. They are thinking about going global. So, you know, it's ultimately doing it, you know. Talking could be easy, but divide task, complete it, prototype, move to the next one. So rightly said, Siddharth, taking baby steps.
Sure, wonderful. Thank you so much. Okay, now moving to the next is trends, right? Now there are so many people who come with this mindset that, look, if there is a new trend that is coming up, you know, I would capture that trend and make money out of it. Now, I personally, Sameer, I'm not a fan of catching up with the trends. You will have many business gurus speaking, oh, you have to catch up that trend, right? So we will talk both sides, basically, right? So let me give you a small little example. We had a hotelier friend of mine, right? And he used to, finest hotel, I would say, one of the finest hotels in Navi Mumbai as such, right? And then we have longer discussions. So when this pandemic hit, he called me and he was really worried because rents are involved, employee salaries are involved, right? And hotel is one industry where you completely have to rely on the people coming to you, sitting inside your ambience and then eating. And correct, and this isn't a super specialty restaurant that we are talking about. This is not just some fast food outlet that we are talking about, right? Now, he actually was of the opinion of catching up the trend. So what he did, Sameer, he started selling, you know, fish, right? And this might sound very silly to some, right? But trust me, he's making more money today than what he used to make in his hotel business, right? Now, there is a reason why he could do this, right? And I will not take a lot of credit for it, but yes, we have had a conversation. I explained to him a concept called the superfan concept, right? Now, again, this is not my concept. Kevin Kelly, you know, he said, you know, if you have 1,000 superfans, right, you can trend or you can go and start a new business and make sure that these people will follow you. And I'm not talking about just followers. You can have millions and millions of followers, right? But these are not super fans. Super fans are those people who will follow you, who will buy things from you, whatever you sell, whatever you do, right? For example, when we started Celebrity School, Sameer, it was a huge investment, right? The website and the AWS hosting, and then meeting these celebrities, shooting with them, right? But then I was 100% sure of one thing, that I have these super fans of mine, right, who would at least come on platform and buy my courses. I was 100% sure of that, right? And this is exactly what happened. In just about three and a half months of launching, I had 1,200 of my courses sold without any marketing amount spent, right? So if you have a super fan like this, definitely go ahead and catch a trend and start a new business. So now this is the same thing what this friend of mine did. You know, he, every customer who came to him, you know, he used to take his name, his mobile number, his email ID, and he was curating what we call in business term as the list, right? Now of that list, he definitely had this super fans whom he used to give away free recipes and tell give away discounts and coupons, right? So on his entire list, he had this wonderful set of I think 2,500 super fans as such. So the moment he started his fish business, these people knew that he's gonna give quality product. These people knew that he's gonna give great product at reasonable prices, right? So immediately he had 2,500 customers, you know, buying from him. Now, trust me, every week, if you have 2,500 customers buying your product, which is maybe about 2,500 rupees worth of fish, that's a decent amount of money, right? So if you have the super fans with you, right, you should actually go ahead and look up to the new trends. And if you don't have, this is the time to start building your list. Because there are, as I said, there are going to be times, tougher times, right, where you will have to divert the business, or you will have to, you know, go ahead and again revamp your business. The only thing that is going to help you are these super fans of yours, right? So first, very simple, you every customer that who buys your product, you have to have his name, his email ID. Right. Second thing, you will have to give as much free information or free things to him as possible, correct, so that he turns into a super fan. Right. It is not a very easy process. It takes time. There are people who will take 3 months and 5 months and 6 months and 1 year to become a super fan. But the best part is once they are your super fan, they are your fan for life as such. Right. OK, you want to add something here, Sameer?
Nee, absolutely. So, you know, ultimately in this world, data is more expensive than oil now. So list also is an advanced version of data. And then we are talking about data analytics and MarTech and convergence. But the primary premise for data is hardcore customer data. Are you really doing some basic level of entrepreneurship? Initiatives of really reaching out to our customers, even though they are not buying, you know?
Very true.
And
very
customers true. Could be internal customers, your own employees, your manufacturing teams, your sales teams, your distributors, and they could be people who pay you. So I think yes, it's high time for all of us entrepreneurs and business owners that we now have, we exactly know who is buying from us, and then try to replace it, or maybe try to replicate it to similar looking audience in physical world and in digital world. So absolutely. Get grip of your thing, put it on a piece of Excel sheet. Who is your customer? So true, Siddharth.
Wonderful. Okay. So now coming back to the fifth and again, the most essential part, right? Social media is going to be your friend. In whatever business you are, you have to have great social media presence, right? Because this is the difference between a star and a superstar, the star and a superstar, right? I see so many companies coming up to me and with huge turnovers, right? And when they come to me for business consultancy and I say, okay, show me your social media page, and you'd be surprised, they don't even have a Facebook page. They don't even have an YouTube page. They don't even have an Instagram or Twitter page. Right now, one, if you don't have a page, that means two things. Point number one, you are not interested in giving back. You're just interested in selling, right? And that is an absolute wrong way, a very short-term way to approach business. Second thing, you are never then going to create a super fan for your business, right? You will have to keep going ahead and acquiring new people, which is tough. There is competition. Absolute competition, right? So you will have to have, and this can be any business. It can be a small mom and pop shop. It can be a very small fast food outlet in some part, right? Create a social media presence in that area so that anyone, if he or she thinks about buying your product, right, he or she should buy it from you. It doesn't have to be a global product. Now, there is again a young girl, Pragya, right, who came to me. She quit her job, right, a very gutsy thing to do, and started her own venture. And she came back to me and said, Siddharth, sir, I want some little advice from you. I'm planning to start my YouTube channel, right? And I said, wonderful, please go ahead. So how many views do you want on your YouTube videos? And she said, oh, sir, I have written it everything down. And my goal is to have 1 million YouTube views on my channel. Now, I'll tell you, Sameer, if you start a YouTube channel with that mindset, you are doomed for failure. Correct? 1 million views mean nothing if that person is not part of your business, if that person is not gonna ever care for you, your business, or buy anything from you, then that views don't mean anything. We are not into the entertainment industries where views matter. When I put up a video, you know, Sameer, what is, how many views I love? I want one view. I want one view from one college or one corporate company who says, Siddharth, we loved your video, come and motivate our students. Siddharth, we loved your video, come and speak to our employees, right? So I only target that one viewer and not 1 million. Because when you think about this mindset of having 1 million views, then you start creating content for everyone, right? And as we said, a content for everyone is content for no one. Correct. So again, coming back to social media, you should have beautiful social media presence. Please don't go ahead and hire these companies who do social media. I'm so sorry, the social media companies here, right? But then they are just gonna have these formats, what they have for all other businesses, put your logo and your images and your some text, what they understand about your business, and keep posting it. Please don't do that. Right? Have the most trusted person on your in your company plan the entire 1 month of content sitting with you. It's your company. You know what has to be spoken and not some marketing person sitting there. Right? So tell the people how you operate. Tell them beautiful things that they should do to, you know, safeguard themselves or what can add value to their lives as such. Right? Just a thought, one beautiful point before we go into the question answer session, Sameer. You know, there are many big companies who come to me for consultancy and say, oh sir, when can we post? What is the best time to post? Right? And they get so much caught up in that. Oh, should we post at 12 o'clock in the night? Should we post at 7 o'clock in the morning? Should we post at 2 o'clock in the afternoon? And here is my take on this, Sameer. Right? Let's take an example that I come to your house and I want to give you 10 lakh rupees. When is that you want me to come? Do you want me to come at 12 o'clock? Do you want me to come at 8 o'clock, 2 o'clock, or anytime is fine? You tell me.
Anytime is good.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Right? So if your content is going to be worth $1 million of worth content, beautiful content that people want, then it does not really matter what time you post it. What matters is how important and how helpful that content is.
True.
Right? Wonderful. Now, before taking the question and answers, Sameer, I've just made this cute little list, right? Sure. And I will quickly go through it. If there are some young entrepreneurs who just want to start their business, right? These are the industries that I think are going to absolutely rock moving ahead.
So that was right? My question to you anyways. Which are the industries should one look at now for young entrepreneurs?
Absolutely. The first industry I would say is online entrepreneurship and online education. And Sameer, it takes absolute guts to keep running celebrity school and yet saying and increasing your own competition. But yes, this is true. Online education is gonna rock. Online education is the way to go forward. And we don't always need celebrities like Nawazuddin Siddiqui the way we have it in celebrityschool.in. I have had students who teach Excel online and are making 5 lakh rupees, Sameer, every month.
Yes.
Right? So online, as many people want to come into online education, you are welcome. This industry is going to grow. This industry is going to boom as such. Right? So first would be online education. Second would be digital marketing, right? As I said, people are always on their phones today or on their Instagrams and Facebooks, and you keep seeing these ads, right? And now people, you know, with this Sushant Singh movement as well, right? People are so connected. Gone are the days when we did not care. Today we care. Today we care for everyone around us. Today we care for the country. Today we care for the local businesses, right? So I would love to buy from a local vendor rather than buy some Chinese product, right? So if you are into social media marketing, digital marketing, you are going to have huge opportunities because everyone is going to come to you now and ask for, you know, doing the social media as such. And don't run behind the bigger companies. They already have their vendors, you know. Go ahead and pitch your product to the smaller vendors who really need you, and they would be with you, stick with you for all their life. If you go ahead and hit the local vendor, right, he's going to be with you for 30, 40 years rather than a multinational company who changes every year, and every 2 years they change the new agency as such. Right. So social media marketing. Second thing, I don't know how many people will agree with this, but agriculture, organic agriculture, organic products is again going to see a lot of boom. Right. Of all the people that I have spoken to because of this corona pandemic, you know, they have told me we would love to have organic food properly wrapped, delivered to my house, right? Rather than buying from the local vegetable vendor here, correct? And I was just speaking yesterday to a doctor, right, from Delhi, who is also an actress, you know, and she actually has taken Nawazuddin Siddiqui's course. And she told me, Siddharth, you'll have to be careful because most of the times, the spread of corona is because of we taking this vegetables from local vendors, right? Or we going to these smaller shops. We don't realize it, but yes, it is one of the reasons for the spread of corona. So if you are into agriculture and if you love that, if you are passionate about it, if you want to just take it as a business, please don't take it, right? But yes, if you love it, you know, and if you want to create something in it, it's a long-term game as such. Second thing, I really loved the way you said that day, gig economy, right? When we had a discussion, gig economy is again gonna boom, Sameer, right? Now, gig economy for our users is where you don't have anyone on your payroll, right? But you have this freelancers, 100 and 200, 500, thousands of freelancers, right? Who you have on your platform, right? And you take up work from a bigger company and you pass it on to this gig workers of yours, right? Now it is very cost effective. And in during this situation, there are many people who have lost their jobs. You know, so unfortunate, Sameer, that I get call almost every day from people who say, sir, I was making 70, 80,000 rupees a month, but I'm ready to work for you for 20, 25,000 rupees. Very unfortunate, Sameer, but this is the situation that we are in. Many major companies have laid down employees, you know, 30, 35% employees have been laid down, right? Now, all of them need work. All of them need job. They are very good at their work. So if someone goes ahead and creates a platform where, you know, you collaborate with these people and, you know, give them work and, you know, you have your fees charged, that industry is again going to be a boom as such. Okay. So, Sameer, I think we are open to take questions. I can keep speaking, but I guess we should take up some questions as well.
My team has lined up plenty of questions for you. But let me take, I'm just compiling them and putting into 2-3. So again, you know, see, because many of our recipients of this information are family businesses, you know, and I also understand in one of your other roles, you consult and you guide entrepreneurs and traditional family businesses to become modern and all. So what are the 3 or 4 big challenges your entrepreneur, this family businesses are facing whom they are coming to you now, and what solutions you are giving them now? How do they start from this deadlock?
Wonderful, wonderful. Point number one, I think there has to be a shift in the mindset. Most of the people or businesses who come to me for consultancy nowadays, they are so rigid, right? They say, oh, no, this thing is going to get over in 3 months and 4 months, and we would be back in our track, and you're asking us to completely revamp the business, right? Point number one, Sameer, 3-4 months is just too shorter of a period. We are not going to get back on our feet in 3 and 4 months. This is going to take time. This is going to take maybe a year to completely come down to normal. And even after it comes down to normal, we are not going to see the same trends, right? This is going to hit the economy very badly, right? For example, my son Vihan, we have told him very clearly, Sameer, that till the time he gets vaccine, right, and till the time after, even after the vaccine, he sits home at 3 months, only then I'm going to tell send him to the school. And this is what every parent is going to do, right? Yes. All the parents who can actually afford, they are telling their children that, look, if you are operating from home, fair enough, but if they are calling you to their office, don't go, it's okay if you sit home. Right? So it's not going to be so much that in 3-4 months, people are going to come back to normal. No. So I think they'll have to, point number one, shift the mindset and adopt to the fact that, look, computers are coming. Social media is big. Right? So first thing would be the shift of mindset. Second thing, they will have to adopt technology a lot. I love the way when you said, Sameer, that there are so many businesses who don't even know how easy it is for them to deliver their product, you know, to the consumer's house, right? There are just too many, delivery companies
delivery companies. Yeah.
Absolutely. And there are too many. We just know about the bigger guys, the Blue Darts and the FedExes, who are very expensive, right? And they may not go to a very local pin code. But there are just too many companies who will come to your shop, pick up the product, take it to the consumer, and charge you nothing. They charge you just so less. I know companies who charge you only 6 rupees for the delivery. Correct? And we don't even think about it. They're not even ready and open to think about it. So you will have to adopt technology. You will have to learn how this technology works. You will have to do a lot of research as such. Correct? And second thing, as I said, you will have to make changes to your process. For example, there was this one company who came to me. They run some 4 fast food outlets, right? And then just 3 months back, they were completely out, absolutely disturbed, right? A huge chunk of money they were making, and suddenly there is no revenue, right? So I kind of guided them, and about 15 days back, they have again started their journey. So when they started their journey, they realized that, look, we will have to make changes to our process as well. For example, if someone orders maybe a pizza, right, and you are taking that usual 30 minutes of time, and that delivery guy is going to come in 45 minutes because he is going to be pressed for time, right? So you cannot have your pizza lying 15 minutes outside getting cold, right? So you'll have to redesign your entire process that you slowly understand, oh, what time he comes. And what time I should start building my pizza or making my pizza, and I'll have to have an oven which keeps it hot. I can't keep it lying down there because then I'm gonna break the customers, right? So you'll have to revamp the whole process to adjust to the new system of technology or new way to reaching the customers as such, right? And finally, coming down, as I said, it's not that rocket science. I have worked with just too many companies. You sit down and you break that entire process into smaller chunks and smaller tasks, you know, and then make developments or use technology to automate this task, and it's actually going to work out very nice for you.
Also, Siddharth, I wanted to, you know, because you are also a trainer and a motivational speaker. So something to really make up the minds of our young entrepreneurs, you know, what is the mental makeup or framework they need from now, because they have to go back to business.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
So what would you suggest there?
Correct. I'll tell you one thing. Every day I get thousands of emails, trust me, thousands of emails, you know, saying, sir, thank you so much for your business course. And trust me, we feel very proud about it, right? Because India today needs as many entrepreneurs as possible, right? The only thing that can save the Indian economy, can actually make us superstars, is the new age entrepreneurs, right? Because when you have this new age modern entrepreneurs coming in, right, you employ people. Right. And India today faces the biggest problem of unemployment. Right. And when I mean unemployment, I just don't mean unemployment in terms of money. Right. A person going to an office and if he's not happy there, for me, that is absolute unemployment. because then he's only giving 20% of his resources or his capacity, right? When young entrepreneurs like you, Samir, come in, right, you create a team where you give them a lot of freedom, correct? Where 100% of their potential is utilized. Now that's 100% employment for me, correct? So India today needs as many entrepreneurs as possible. There are just too many problems to be solved. Every one of us can pick up one problem, start solving, employ 5-10 people, and then go to 100 people. And trust me, we can become a global power in that sense, right? So the mindset, what I would like to suggest here is that, trust me, entrepreneurship is very easy today. There were times, Samir, when you and me started, it was, trust me, very difficult to formulate a company, to have the legal work, the paperwork, you know, getting people. Today, it's just so simple. I've had many of my students with just 5,000 rupees starting up their website, right, and starting their business. And you don't have to know everything about a business on the day one. Start the business, launch, fail. Think what went go wrong, right? Remodify the business and then keep making changes and growing, right? So please come in. We are all there to help, you know, people like me, Samir, and there's so many of us who are very passionate about you coming into business. We're all there to help you, right? And so that we all can grow together as such, right? So giving one advice, Samir, would be don't think much. Come here, learn along the way, you know, and then you would reach success.
So, and I completely agree, you know, this is the time to start now. If you don't have a business and you are still struggling, what do I do after graduation? Or if I had a good job and now I am probably unemployed or I have been retrenched, it's no reason to be, you know, worried. Or maybe some existing business which went on for, which was a retail customer facing business, and because of this current situation, it's not generating those kind of revenues. I don't think one needs to now, you know, keep repenting on that. The idea is to start something new. Take help from people who can help you to restart. I think that's right. A good idea. Siddharth, since we are running short of time, but I still want you to, in maybe next 5 minutes, tell us what do you do at Celebrity School, and you can use backdrop of Celebrity School and just tell us the business model. How did you build this entire huge business globally? And that's a new age online learning enterprise business. So from ideation to today, what you are, you can give it as an example for our young audience.
Absolutely. Right. So coming with the same story that I told you first, you know, we knew that something like this is going to hit our business, right? Maybe not exactly a corona thing we knew, but we knew that there is something which is going to make us, you know, deviate into our business. We cannot rely on our trainers going physically to the schools and teaching. We had to make some fallback plan. So our fallback plan was an online education platform as such. And then we had two options, that we teach the same thing, right, online. Or the second thing we saw, that everyone, Samir, right, wants to live their passion. We all fight, we all thrive so that we can, you know, dance, sing, laugh, and be happy, correct? And the things that actually make us happy is when we live or we do what we really love to do. For example, acting, singing, these are very passion related careers and courses as such. And this is what we realized when we went down to the smaller towns in India, or even corporate houses where I used to take my sessions. There are many people who came to me and said, you know what, sir, I make 2 lakh rupees a month, but this is not what I wanted to do. I wanted to become an actor. I wanted to become a singer. Right, we went to some engineering college in Chhattisgarh, and there are people who came to us and said, sir, I'm very good here, but you know what, my real passion, love, lies in making films and telling stories as such, right? But we don't have people to guide us and support us as such. So this is where we realized, why not build a platform where you get the best of the best celebrities, right? And when I mean celebrities, I mean people who really struggled their way up, who are very passionate about what they are doing. They are open to sharing each and everything about their journey, their tips, their secrets, their tactics as such, right? So we met these people. Fortunately, Nawaz sir, Madhur Bhandarkar sir, Shan sir, Sabira Merchant, right? I had worked with them before, and I really appreciated what they did we approach them with a proper business plan and passion that what we exactly want to do, right? And how we want to really make a change in the lives of the people so that they feel confident. You know, the whole platform, Sameer, is not so that someone becomes a superstar in celebrity school. That's definitely they will become if they have talent. The whole platform gives them an opportunity to feel confident about themselves, right? They can go ahead that, look, I have learned from Nawazuddin Siddiqui. I'm confident enough. I can go and face the world, right? So this is all how it started. Fortunately, we got wonderful response. If you see our social media posts as well, if you see the comments on them, there's a beautiful community that's been formed. And I'll tell you the reason for it as such. There are many companies who said, oh, we want to invest into celebrity school, right? And let's have discussions about it. But you know what? You have made this post about Sushant Singh Rajput. Can you please delete that post? Because that doesn't go well with our investor's mindset. And we said, absolutely no. That's what we stand for. Right, we are the voice of the young people. We have hundreds of messages and emails, you know, and replies on that post. Thank you, sir. How nice of you to be in this industry and yet put a post, and you have the best of the best superstars hiding and not even speaking about it. And it's a gutsy thing. Of course, it's a gutsy thing. And we, you know, want only those people as trainers on our platform who stand for something, you know, who are actually passionate about what they are doing and passionate about teaching. So that's how it came. And something you created out of passion, Sameer, is always going to be successful.
Super. So where are you all now? At what stage of the business are you all currently in? And how, when did you start this? And where is it now? And what's the plan? How does this business model scale now?
Okay. We officially launched in October. Right. I think that was a time when we had our first user paying us money as such. Right. But this has been in the making for about 1 year, because meeting the stars, talking with them, editing. If you see our promos also, you know, they are everything is shot as if we are shooting a movie. The promos have been edited as if they're editing, and color graded as if they're editing and color grading a film promo as such. Right. So 1 year we have been. Today we have almost 40,000 users as such, paid users as such. We have almost 2 lakh people on our newsletter list, right, whom we keep sharing information about. Going ahead, what we think is never in numbers, Sameer. We think that we should have 100 top trainers from different fields, different passion fields on our platform. Let it be chess, let it be music composing, or let it be presentation skills as such, right? So this is not necessarily a very Bollywood thing that we want to make it, right? Mm-hmm. Anything related to passion. Someone is passionate about writing, oh, please come to Celebrity School and we will have a trainer write for your need. So yes, we are planning 100 top trainers from different fields to be on the platform.
Fantastic. So, you know, very clearly your journey also exactly exhibits what you are training entrepreneurs. It's about customer centricity, empathy. It's about combining technology with new age business models and then scaling up like a startup.
So, thank you. Siddharth, thank you so much.
Thank you very much for your time and guiding our young entrepreneurs. On behalf of the Wellinker Institute of Management and Yanko Executive Education, from the heart, thank you to you, and we would love to have you on our campus when things resume very soon. Yeah,
certainly.
So,
certainly
best of luck for your venture, and let's keep in touch. Yeah,
thank you so much.
Thank
All
you
the
very
best.
Much,
appreciate what you guys are doing as well. Thank you so much. Bye.
Bye.